Aquarius, wherever it sits, or the Lord where it goes. Okay, I'm not repeating. There will, or that relative of that house, will have some story with property. Or inheritance. Or some issue would come in the property. Test it right now.
Sir, may I speak one thing, sir?
Yes, Shailendra.
Sir, like you, I told you that my ninth lord, Aquarius, my ninth lord, which is Aquarius, the ninth lord is sitting in the sixth, which is the house of maternal uncle. So he got huge inheritance, above 1500 crore rupees. Still, he stays in my house over rent. Okay. And he is badly miser kind of person that, matlab, even he, if he buys a 24-inch TV, he will measure it by scale. Is it exactly 24 inches or not?
Oh my God. So everybody listen to what he said. As I said, there will be some story regarding property. Now he has 1500 crores, but yet he is staying on rent
in my house, sir.
In your house. So that's a wonderful feedback. Others have also given. Various. It's not on Aquarius Lagna. It is only on the sign of Aquarius. There are some traits. Like this is what... This is a part of the JPC course, Jyotish Pandit course that you started. And my lectures on Saturday are extra lectures. Otherwise, we follow the curriculum, which happens on Sunday. Saturday, what I teach, I finish only two signs or three signs, is how to predict on blank charts. No planets. Planets come later. The first part is to understand how, if somebody tells you only the Lagna, how to predict at least 60 events. Or sometimes the nature of what could happen. Now JPC course 2 should start in April, March, and I wonder if my health permits, or it might start in April. Now, let us understand Aquarius. It is the 11th sign of the zodiac. So the first and foremost thing for any Lagna is you put the imprint of Aquarius. Aquarius, wherever it sits in any horoscope, there will always be, I want something. That I want something will be very enforced. It will have a lot of power in it. So, for example, Mithun Lagna, Aquarius comes in the ninth house. So ninth house is Bhagya. Along with Bhagya, sometimes fame also comes. So, in whatever profession you're dealing with, your profession is also linked to your Bhagya. If you have Bhagya, you'll have good profession. You will always have that desire, I want more. In my olden days, there was an ad of Pepsi. They had a tagline. I do not know if now they still have the tagline. Ye dil mange more. In English, if I translate it, it means your heart asks for more in that area of life. Say for Karka Lagna, Aquarius comes in 8th house. So one would want 8th house significations. What are 8th house significations? Inheritance, in-laws,
occult knowledge.
Sorry?
Occult knowledge.
Yes. So, Karka Lagna people can have slightly selfish relatives or people who will always secure themselves first. Karka Lagna people, if they get into astrology, they will or they can do a lot of hard work to learn mantra, tantra or astrology, or they can go to any extent to get that. Now, how do you deal with, what is the normal technique? I always tell people something that was not written about. When you're dealing with a sign, you're putting that sign in that house. You're observing the house, mixing the sign. Then at the same time, your third shed should be where the lord of that sign goes. So for Aquarius, there are two lords. One is Saturn and second is Rahu, the co-lord. So you have to observe now where the co-lord and Saturn, where both are sitting. It will carry the same traits. Ye dil mange more. My heart wants more. Is the first part of the technique working in people's charts? Can 3-4 people just give an audio feedback?
It's working in my chart.
Okay, you need not say, let me say something. You know, you need not say it is your chart. You can always say, yes, it's working on native, whenever you take an example.
Got it.
Yeah, in my neighbor's chart, it is working, sir.
Okay. Kindly give audio feedback because chat.
Sir, I have the Gemini ascendant. And ninth house lord is sitting in the sixth house, that is Saturn. And I had always this resentment about my father, though he was a very good father during my childhood, that he could have done better during my childhood days. So this resentment has not still died down.
It's so important that you could remember it. That means it must be really important. Anybody else wants to give feedback? Shivam Bali says,
sir, one feedback I can share from an interesting chart. A person I know, he has Virgo Lagna. His Aquarius sign goes into the sixth house. So he has a lot of intensity towards his relationship with his maternal uncle, Mama.
Mama.
So, and he is really obsessed with that. So this is quite peculiar because these days you don't find such kind of intensity, but it is there.
Thank you, Manish.
In a few charts, I have seen this technique working, but in one chart where it is an ascendant and the ascendant Lord Saturn is debilitated. So there it is totally not working.
No, come again.
Maybe because the Saturn is debilitated. So I have seen that person that he never said that she wants something.
Okay.
Matlab, people have to tell ki at least say it, then only you will get silently going through.
What is the ascendant?
Ascendant is Aquarius only.
Okay. And where is...
And Rahu is there.
Where is Saturn and Rahu?
It is in the third house, 14 degrees. Aries 14 degrees, Saturn. And Rahu is in the ascendant, 28 degrees.
And does he have siblings?
Yes.
Is it working on his siblings charts?
They want something. Yes, they must be wanting things in life.
Not wanting. I'm talking here about not want. I'm talking about lot of want.
No.
Lot of want in some area of life.
No.
Okay.
Even in siblings, can't see lot of want.
Okay, fine. Thanks, Shalini, for the feedback.
Thank you. Sir, would it be obsession or want in that area of life, sir?
Both are actually border on the same. When you see the PPT,
right,
you
sir?
See the word obsession.
Okay.
But both actually border on the same lines.
Okay. Thank you.
Can you see the screen, sir?
Yes. Now I can.
Okay, sir.
Pratik Vyas gives one feedback. He knows a person, Cancer Lagna, and his in-laws always seek financial help from him. Thank you, Pratik. Okay, next slide, Neeraj. Rajni, what is true? You're writing, it is true, but again, the font is not coming. Anyway, forget it. Forget it. See, take a screenshot of this right now and paste it in a Word file or something. Everybody kindly do this because you'll need to remember this. The first is wherever Aquarius sits or wherever its Lord or co-Lord goes, there is possibility of tragedy in that area or in the life of that relative signified by the house. So if it is in third house, it is siblings, not necessary that siblings is only young, third house is only younger siblings. I've explained this so many times. Floyd says true, Aquarius 10th house, father died at age 20. There is tragedy over there. now the other point is wherever Aquarius will sit, the house or the house lord where it goes, one can do charity or work in that area. Third is, wherever Aquarius sits, stomach ailment or heart problems or breathing issues or feet problems to that related. So suppose it is sixth house, it can be relatives in general, it can be maternal uncles or uncles. Eleventh house, not just siblings or elder siblings, but also father's family or father's siblings. Freud gives feedback, yes, my father had heart problem. 10th house is Aquarius. Even for a Gemini Lagna, the father can have heart problems. Fourth point, wherever Aquarius sits, that house relative can have intoxication problems or substance abuse or some form of obsession. The first point we had discussed before the start of the PPT was obsession. So many people, that dil mange more. So that obsession is here. Now this point, he also gives a feedback, my father had cigarette addiction. This point is a tough point. The house where Aquarius sits or where its lord goes, you can have heartbreak in that area of life, which is similar to the point of tragedy, or that relative can have something. I hope people have taken screenshots of this, because after this there will be charts, 10 charts, examples. You'll have to remember all this. Archana Mehta writes, confirmed tragedy for that relative, substance abuse, heartbreak, hand activated at the age of 45. All correct. Rajni writes, my husband is Aquarius ascendant, addicted to Pan Parag. So that obsession or substance abuse rather. Floyd, heartbreak in what sense means? Any area of life, they would have wanted something, either not got it or lost it, which for life they will keep it in their mind, you know. Shalini writes, true tragedy for self in ascendant. Now, Aquarius gets activated at the age of 24, 45, 47, 48. out of many ages, I have given only four so that you all remember it. My problem is I know so many ages, I don't remember it while seeing a chart. Shailendra writes, my father, pan addict. See, for Libra Lagna, Aquarius will be in the fifth house. Fifth house is mind. Fifth house is many things. So, our great legend astrologer, K.N. Rao Saab, he drinks a lot of tea. He is Libra Lagna. He also has a lot of pan. Mahatma Gandhi, Libra Lagna, Aquarius in the fifth house. He was obsessed with Satyagraha movement. He was obsessed in controlling his sex. Are you all getting it? He was obsessed. If I remember well, he had Saturn in the second house. Anybody has Mahatma Gandhi chart? Can they double check? My software is not working. So, Rahu Moon in the 10th house, Ketu in the 4th house, Jupiter Vakri in the 7th house, Sun in the 12th house. Let's check anybody. Venus Mars in the 1st house, Saturn should be in the 2nd house. 2nd house is the house of food. His obsession was to fight the Britishers with fasting.
Sir, can I share him the chart of Mahatma Gandhi?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yes, sir, this is.
See, correct. Saturn in second house. Again, in the sign of obsession, Scorpio. All right, you can go back to the PPT. So, it is, by the way, if everybody observed, his Saturn is with Arudha Lagna. So these Arudha Lagna is your image. These obsessions gave him an image to the world. People today remember Mahatma Gandhi for Satyagraha, for fasting. You know? Anyway.
My Lagna is Capricorn.
Okay.
Aquarius becomes the second house.
Yeah.
And my Saturn is in the fifth house, Taurus.
Okay.
I got into astrology at the age of 48.
Achha.
इससे ज़्यादा मेरा कोई भी ज़िंदगी में obsession नहीं है. किसी भी चीज़ के बारे में जो मिल गया मुकद्दर समझ लिया. कोई ऐसा अभी भी नहीं है कि एस्ट्रोलॉजी में मुझे कोई बहुत तोपे मारनी है. जो मिल रहा है बहुत बढ़िया है. बस एक ही चीज़ है मेरे दिमाग में कि अपनी मरने तक खुद मैं अपनी रोटी पानी कमा सकूं. बस दैट इज़ ऑल. और वो जो लास्ट टाइम में समझ कि जहाँ राहु रहता है, वेर एवर राहु इज सिटिंग एट द एज ऑफ 34, वो चीज़ प्रॉस्पर होती है. तो माई राहु इज इन द 9th हाउस. सो इन माई 34th ईयर माई दिस वर्क गॉट स्टार्टेड विच आई एम डूइंग फॉर द लास्ट 47 ईयर्स. which I'm still active with.
Okay.
So, this is my story.
Thank you. I'll translate it in English for the South Indians and foreigners.
Sorry, I forgot to talk in English.
Okay, sorry. No problem, sir. Aquarius, Neeraj, your screen sharing is not working. Kindly reshare. Aquarius is in his second house, Parashar-ji's. And Saturn is in second house?
Saturn is in Taurus, fifth house.
Fifth house.
And Rahu is in the ninth house, Virgo.
Okay. So, at the age of 48, which is one of the activation years of Aquarius, his obsession started with
astrology.
And also, he is in a profession from the last 47 years. And it started at the age of 34, which in last webinar I had taken the lecture on, ki wherever Rahu sits at the age of 34, that house gets activated, or where it Lord goes and sits, it gets activated. So his profession started, the current profession that he is in, from the last 47 years, okay, at the age of 34 it started. Next, he is also obsessed with the point that he should be able to earn on his own even at this age. Parashar-ji, your age right now is 77 or 78?
No. God willing, I should be 80 by August 12.
Okay. Wonderful, sir. Wonderful. Just give me 1 second, sir. Sorry. And there was one more point that I wanted to say. So at the age of 80 also, he wants to be self-reliant and self-sufficient. So second house is the house of wealth, money and income also. So it shows how it is working. I'll repeat, kindly memorize everybody. 24, 45, 47, 48. Maybe in future I'll reveal more of the years I have for all the signs and for all the houses. So it's very important and beautiful how things work. Always remember, plus minus few months can happen, you know, it works out really well. Okay. Now there is one, I'll take a break, I'm a bit tired, okay. There is one thing, wherever background kisi ka mute kar dijiye, background noise kafi aa raha hai. Wherever Rahu sits, 36th year or 36.5, it gets activated, or where its Lord goes and sits. So this I have found working sometimes very beautifully, and there are few charts I have found it not working at all, or I did not know the event of the person, you know. Because on Facebook, you know, you can ask limited questions. You post something I recently posted about this 36.5. And if you start interacting, people start private messaging. And then, it becomes a problem. I am just muting everybody for a second. Okay, you can unmute yourself whenever you all want to speak. Test this out while I'm taking a 5 minute break and put it in the chat box. You know, I become a bit breathless. I do not know how I will be able to take the lecture, but because there are a lot of slides. So some people have given feedback. Manish says, I am Libra ascendant and Rahu is in 9th house and I got my second baby at the age of 36.5. Now, 9th house is Arud of the 5th house. So always remember Bhavat Bhavam 5th to 5th. So 9th house is very important for children. Manjunatha Shastri says, Sir, I got married at the age of 36. Rahu is in 7th house of marriage. Now, Charlotte says, Thank you, sir. The technique is effective. 36th year, Rahu in 5th, Pisces ascendant, started astrology professionally just by hearing two lines from a great astrologer. Many, many principles of astrology got cleared at the very moment. Okay, this is the chart of Jamie Lee Curtis, Sagittarius ascendant. I had mentioned wherever Aquarius sits, there is tragedy or heartbreak. Saturn is aspecting from Lagna, it is aspecting the third house of younger brothers or siblings. Co-lord Rahu goes in 10th house, but in Virgo sign. Virgo is the natural 6th house. 6th house is Akala Mrityu, untimely death. 6th house is diseases. Okay. Now, see here. Go to the next one. Okay. Her brother Nicholas Curtis died suddenly due to heroin overdose. He was just 24 years old at the time of death. Next. There was a lot of media downpour, you know. No. Go left. Speculation and mudslinging following the death. Now, one important principle that I wanted to say. Okay. See, third house is aspected by Saturn. It is also aspected by Jupiter. Any house, either Jupiter-Saturn conjunct or any house aspecting it, you can take it that lot of events will happen. It will give obstacles also. Right now, Saturn and Jupiter are conjunct. And the obstacles we face is COVID. It is in Capricorn. The problem is not going. The problem would have started earlier. Okay. But from Capricorn, Saturn and Jupiter are aspecting one sign, which is Pisces. Pisces is the natural 12th house of hospitalization, diseases, etc. And that is what is happening. Many people are getting hospitalized, etc. and all that. In India's chart, which is Taurus Lagna, you have Aquarius in the 10th house. Does anybody have India's chart? Anirish, do you have India's chart? Or I have it? Wait. I'll share, but I cannot share. That is a problem. It is 1 second. No, I'm not able to share. Okay. Just mentally create on a piece of paper, Taurus Lagna. Aquarius in the 10th house. The lot of it, Saturn goes in the third house. So third house is the house of neighbors. We have problems with our neighbors, whether it is Pakistan or China or Bangladesh, whatever. Saturn and Jupiter, Saturn is in the third house, so it will aspect the 12th house. It will aspect the 12th house. Jupiter is in sixth house, so it is aspecting the 12th house. So you have a common factor. 12th house is again secret enemies. Both this technique you combine, you get the problem. This will remain almost an eternal problem. Go back to the slide. Now, one technique I forgot to mention. Screen share for a second. Aquarius, wherever it sits, or the Lord where it goes. Okay, I'm not repeating. There will, or that relative of that house, will have some story with property. Or inheritance. Or some issue would come in the property. Test it right now.
Sir, I want to share one feedback on this. Can I share?
Yes, yes.
I am again Libra Lagna, Aquarius in the fifth, and Rahu is in the ninth house. My father, my grandfather has left lot of property, and my father has done lot of struggle to get it properly divided. So there was a lot of issues with him. And then when my son born, fifth house, I had a flat and I was facing lot of issue, and I named after him, and my problem got sorted out. So from both the ends, my father's side and from my son's side, some story is there with the property.
Thank you. Thank you for the feedback.
Sir, may I speak one thing, sir?
Yes, sir.
Sir, like you, I told you that my ninth lord, Aquarius, my ninth lord, which is Aquarius, the ninth lord is sitting in the sixth, which is the house of maternal uncle. So he got huge inheritance, above 50-100 crore rupees. Still, he stays in my house over rent. Okay. And he is badly miser kind of person. That, matlab, even he, if he buys a 24-inch TV, he will measure it by scale. Is it exactly 24 inches or not?
Oh my God. So, everybody listen to what he said. As I said, there will be some story regarding property. Now, he has 1500 crores, but yet he is staying on rent.
In my house, sir.
In your house. So that's a wonderful feedback. Others have also given feedback. Deep Jyoti.
Sir, independent chart dekhna
hai? Nahi, wo ho gaya.
Okay.
Thank you, Amit. Deep Jyoti Das says, I know a Virgo ascendant whose maternal uncle has addiction of tobacco and breathing issue, and also has property issue, totally matching, sir. See, we had mentioned breathing issue at the start. Okay. Aquarius will come in sixth house of maternal uncles. Okay. Now, Prince Verma says, my older sis has issue. Aries Lagna, so Aquarius becomes 11th house of elder sibling. Okay, Saturn, my Saturn in 8th Scorpio. Okay, Shalini Khayal says, true issues with property, though property is beneficial. So there is story involved.
Yes, sir. There is story like the having lots and lots of properties, but cannot directly use the property, that person, and then he cannot even live there, he cannot work there, and has to live in the property which is in other's name. So those properties are with that person, and it is beneficial somehow. It is giving money and respect that way, but directly he cannot use.
Thank you for the feedback. Pratik Vyas says, true, I bought a house in the name of my mother. That property is still in dispute. He is Scorpio Lagna, Aquarius, in fourth house of mother. Okay, that's a good feedback. Rajni Vaidyaraj says, my husband Aquarius ascendant. His father promised his flat to my husband. My father-in-law died. My husband's mom sold the house and my husband left with no house, although house was promised. So true, sir, your principle. Thank you. Dipesh Parmar says, matching for one Virgo ascendant, maternal uncle has addictions and constant disputes with other maternal uncle about property and inheritance. Okay, thank you everybody. Neeraj, you can share the screen. I hope at least some of you realize that these techniques can never be found in any book, you know, or has probably never been shared, you know. Go to next slide. One second. Thank you, Floyd. Thank you. See, all the points were shared by you. Albert Einstein, ninth house is father. Okay. Now, it has Jupiter in it, the 10th lord, and the 7th lord of prominence. Now, the 3rd lord of writing and 9th lord of philosophy and higher knowledge, okay, are getting connected. How? The dispositor of 9th lord Saturn is conjunct Sun, the 3rd lord. And 3rd house is your subconscious mind. Albert Einstein does not need any explanation. He has Venus exalted in the 10th house. So this Venus Saturn is combining with Mercury. And who is this Saturn? Dispositor of Jupiter. Dispositor of 9th house of higher knowledge. He published more than 300 scientific papers, along with over 150 non-scientific works. So the rest you can read. I'm just saving my breath. Next slide. Ninth house is also father. His father did a lot of work. Next slide, please. Next. Oh, by the way, coming back to Albert Einstein, he was... Next. We talked about ninth house obsession. He was also... His ninth lord is conjunct Lagna lord and fifth lord of mind. Fifth lord of addictions. Fifth house is addictions. Okay. Next. Albert Einstein was so obsessed with stars, universe, everybody, that he was blind to everything else. You know, like, he used to forget to eat for a long time. He used to forget to sleep. And when he used to come out of the bathroom, he would remain in his bathrobe for hours. In fact, his wife used to shout at him for this particular quality, this bathrobe quality, that you come after taking bath, so, you know, at least get dressed. Now, his father was a genius, but his career was tragic. He had an electric firm that manufactured dynamos and electrical meters and was instrumental in bringing electricity to Munich. But he lost many contracts and he had to shut down his factory. And he died at a relatively early age due to heart failure. We had mentioned earlier Aquarius heart and worries about money. Okay. Next. So there's something I forgot to mention. Aquarius problem, Aquarius house relative. Okay. I had mentioned tragedy at the start. Okay. It can many a times be with regards to money. Mithuna Lagna people, ninth house is Bhagya, ninth house is father. So at one point of time, the father can have real issues with money or go bankrupt or lose a lot of money. Okay. And another problem that I have forgotten to say, Aquarius sign also connected with stock market or some form of gambling. Check. In some Mithun Lagnas, father could be obsessed with this thing.
It is there, sir, with my father.
Yes. Okay, what Lagna it is?
Mithun Lagna, sir.
Achha.
Sir, does it apply to using your Gemini moon? You know how they do the Chandra Kundli?
Of course. And then it will always work on Chandra Lagna also. All rules of ascendant is applicable on Chandra ascendant also.
And great. Okay, so I can confirm.
What can you confirm?
My father had problems like that. So.
Okay.
My co-brother had this problem. He is from Mithuna Lagna, Gemini.
Achha. Rajesh Kumar says, it's true with me, sir. My father had a habit of gambling. I wish my
yes sir.
I could share screen and my Jagannath Hora was working. I could have shared the charts of some gamblers. Pallavi says father lose his lots of money in share market. Sis has Gemini Lagna. So there also it is working. As I grow old, now when I see the PPT. This PPT was made years ago.
What I was trying to say is,
you know, you realize how much you miss out on sharing knowledge in the PPT. You forget. Yes, please continue.
Sir,
Yes, sir. My ascendant is Aquarius and I am 48 years of age right now. 49 is running and currently I am entering into the stock market. And there's a person who has contacted me who's having a, you know, a Taurus Lagna and having, you know, Rahu in the 11th house. And he's of 34 years of age. So all the dictums which you have said till now and last two dictums are matching perfectly here, I guess.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for the feedback.
Sir, this is Rajni talking. Sorry.
Yes, Rajni.
And I have my daughter who is Mithun Lagna. And her Aquarius is the 9th house. Right. But her father, I'm sorry, I have contrary thing to share with you. He's very opposed to gambling or anything to do with stock market.
That's actually nice to hear. Where is her Saturn and Rahu? Or any aspects on Aquarius? Or any aspects on Aquarius?
I will check, sir. One second. Her Saturn is the 6th house of in Scorpio sign, and
okay, and her Rahu.
So Rahu is in 10th house. He's so opposed to gambling. He doesn't like to see the sign of cards. And he is so against any investment in stock market. He is totally against.
Okay. And any aspects on Aquarius?
No aspect on Aquarius, sir. No.
Any aspects on Saturn?
Not even Saturn.
Any
aspects? On Saturn.
Or Rahu?
Sun and Mars are on Rahu.
Sun and Mars are on Rahu. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
He is so averse to gambling. Like, you don't even want to talk to him about cards or anything.
Rahu is aspecting Saturn, by the way. And Saturn is in Scorpio. Okay. Scorpio is a sign of transformation. Okay.
Okay.
So here the father is transformed, one. Okay. Second is sixth house is also the house of reversals. Sixth house is the house of health and diseases. When we are young, we have normal good health. As we age, it reverses. Our health goes down, at least to normal people, you know. That same concept you put in a philosophical manner, ki sixth house will reverse.
Interesting.
Our relatives, when we are born, are nice to us. As we marry, relatives from the spouse's side are nice. But after some time, this changes. So sixth house, sixth lord will always give reversals. In most
cases. Very interesting.
In most cases. You know, so actually, it's a good chart. You know, so it shows the father's mindset. Good is not doing it. Thank you so much, Rajni.
Yes. Okay. You're welcome, sir.
Yeah.
I asked one question on Saturn and Rahu combination.
Yeah.
Sir, you said Saturn and Rahu, Saturn and Jupiter, wherever Saturn and Jupiter sits, they will create problem in that particular house.
Obstacles.
But Saturn and Jupiter are also from the Karam Dharam Yoga, so just got little confused why they will create problem, because from the Naisargik Kundli they are the ninth lord and tenth lord.
Excellent question, Manish. It is Bhavat Ratnakar, in the Aries chapter, Bhavat Ratnakar is the book on exceptions in Parashari astrology. Many a times he has gone against Parashar Rishi and written this. So it says, Mesha Lagna, Saturn and Jupiter combined will not give yoga. This is something that has, this shloka has baffled the best of astrologers in the last few centuries. Dr. B.V. Raman has written commentary on this book, I think 1955 or 4. And B.V. Raman Saab in the introduction says, wherever Bhavarth Ratnakar has gone contrary to Parashar Rishi also, Dr. Raman Saab has found in his experience in astrology that it works. Bhavarth Ratnakar works. Next, the word obstacles. Okay, write down obstacles, stroke, karma. Saturn, Rahu aspecting one house together. Jupiter, Saturn aspecting one house together. Saturn, Ketu aspecting one house together. Okay. You will have obstacles or heavy karma. Okay. Or where the Lord sits. Or you will do that work in that area. Are you getting it?
Yes, sir. Actually, it's simply amazing.
Yes, my Saturn is in 12th house. My Jupiter is in 8th house. So my 12th house is activated. 12th house is charity. For 7 years, we created a free magazine, digital magazine, not the YouTube channel. I'm talking about the digital magazine. Thousands of pages of articles we created. Thousands. One of our issues had 1500 pages. That's the real work, not the YouTube that I'm doing right now. The real astrology, the real contribution of Saptarishi's astrology was the digital magazine. Only the old timers who read it at that time in 2008, we started it. 2015. I stopped it. When I came on Facebook, I realized I was serving the wrong community of people. You know? So, 12th house is charity. Over there, the 9th lord of higher knowledge, astrology, and also the 8th lord of occult is sitting. So, that charity I'm doing. Getting it? It is with yes, Venus. So I had to spend money from my own pocket when I travel to outstations, etc., and take interviews. Okay, lot of money goes. Lot, huge. Huge amount of money goes.
Yes, sir.
So, and there is no income, you know, for this YouTube videos. It is pretense we get. Anyway, let's come back. Did I miss a point? Okay, this is Prince Arthur's horoscope. See here, the 9th house is Aquarius. 9th house is father. Now, this is aspected by retrograde Jupiter. Okay. And even Mars sitting in the second house of family is aspecting this 9th house. Okay. Now, very important point here is his father died at a young age, and they say he was ill for at least 2 years before his death, which may indicate that a chronic disease like Crohn's disease, I do not know what's Crohn's disease, okay. So there, renal failure, he suffered from renal failure or abdominal cancer was the cause of death. This is what is talked about by historians. And he had long-standing gastric problems. So in our first slide, we had mentioned stomach issues. Okay, it's matching here. Now see from ninth house, whenever we are seeing a house, you catch the whole relative. If you have a health issue or something, okay, Muthu Chidambaram says Crohn's is an inflammatory condition of bowels with diarrhea, loss of weight. Okay, thanks, Mr. Muthu. So we talk of the relative, and if it has body part is also to be seen, from that house we also catch the body part. So from ninth house, sixth house will be second house. Sixth house will be second house of stomach, especially lower stomach. Okay, so he is, this is completely matching to what he is saying. Because there, Rahu, the co-lord of Aquarius, is sitting. Ravi Kumar is saying, sir, I have a similar chart, Gemini ascendant, Jupiter in third and Saturn in 10th, retro in 10th. My father died due to colon cancer and he suffered from gastric. Thanks for the feedback. Anyway, before we go to the next chart, Upendra Singh Badare is asking, say something about Taurus ascendant. Now I want people to come forward and tell me, for Taurus ascendant, Aquarius will be in 10th house. Now we do not know where Saturn and Rahu is there. It is important to know that. But let us use 20% of the technique. Tell me what all issues can happen.
Sir, one issue there might be that a person might have dissatisfaction from the marriage because, or he wanted a better marriage, or like you said, the obsession, because 10th is the fourth from 7th. So marriage-wise, there will be issue. And other thing, I feel that he might have some issue from the bosses too, from in the office, like there some promotion snatched from him or something like that.
Or promotion can create a problem also.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Anybody else? Thank you, Mr. Jha.
Problem with the siblings, problem with the some health challenges with the siblings.
Excellent. Thank you, Rajni ji. Anybody else?
Mother-in-law can be affected.
Mother-in-law. Very good.
Will they be obsessed with their name and fame? You know, like their izzat is like a big issue for them.
Excellent. Excellent, Charlotte.
From my side, sir, it's like this is a good time for them to earn a lot of money.
Okay. Okay. Badureji, whatever people have said, is it right? Mota mota, broadly.
Mota mota right, mota mota thoda right nahi.
Okay, like which issue was not right?
Boss ke saath mein kabhi problem nahi hua.
Okay, career mein?
कैरियर भी जैसा गवर्नमेंट का कैरियर है उसके हिसाब से बढ़िया चलता है. आई डिड नॉट गेट ए सिंगल इवन नोटिस और अ सिंगल पेज, कुछ भी मिला नहीं लाइफ में. बढ़िया से जॉब चला.
ओके एंड व्हिच थिंग्स वेर राइट?
मदर इन लॉ मेरे शादी के लगभग 7-8 साल के बाद मर गई थी, लेकिन वो पहले से बीमार थी जब मेरी शादी.
एनी अदर थिंग दैट वाज राइट?
मैं सुना हूँ कुछ चीज समझ भी नहीं पाया क्या क्या बोल गए.
अच्छा दिस टॉरस असेंडेंट, इफ एनीबडी talks negatively, does that person react very strongly?
Yes.
More than others would do it.
Yes. Definitely.
100% right.
Okay. Health issues to the child.
Yes, it is sixth from the.
Sorry, क्या बोला?
पांचवें से छठा स्थान है इसके लिए बच्चों का. Yes.
And there are problems also regarding income of the child.
It is fluctuated. What he got once upon a time, it is too large amount. Another child is getting 15 lakhs per annum. Though he is at very junior condition, there stays.
Okay.
He is working with Schneider L&T, mechanical engineer. So,
okay.
His job is good.
So I'll just explain in English some of the points that Bhaduraji said in Hindi. The mother-in-law point is correct. Mother-in-law died 7-8 months after the marriage for this native, and due to health issues. So that's a pretty young age of death. And the other point she confirmed was, or rather he said was, career issues, not much, a normal government job, you know, and no problems with boss. Okay. And that's about it. I think I've covered everything. Thank you so much.
Father, what about father?
What about father, Bhaduraji?
Father passed away at the age of 84.
Okay.
Okay, so what I think mature is when he had the position was very good in social as well as financial, like this. And say he is good enough, but 10th house shows some another thing also. Okay, so I will analyze that thing also. Now I got some idea from you just now that you have to analyze that particular house from various angles.
Yeah, from all the 11 houses.
Yes.
From all the 11 houses.
Yes, okay. You are right. You can say that income of my father was also fluctuated income. Okay. So it is the second house from the 9th house.
Right.
Likewise, we can go further and further.
Yeah.
Okay. So I got some good ideas regarding all these things. Regarding, I have ideas as I am using all these things in Laghu Parasri also. But for Aquarius, particular this problematic sign. Who is creating a lot of problem in life, particular where it is situated. I got some ideas, and I will use all these things in my routine life.
Okay.
I got it. Now it is my duty to understand it and to use it and to propagate it.
One quick question. How did the father of this native, how did he expire?
My father?
Yeah.
My father has expired due to the failure of kidney.
Kidney. So that comes in the stomach region. So our first technique also is working. All right. Thank you so much for the feedback. Dasni Diol has given a chart. Taurus ascendant native with Rahu in Aquarius in 10th house and Saturn in 8th house in Sagittarius. So 8th house is chronic diseases. 10th lord in 8th is again problems in career. So now he writes, father is really sick right now, got Parkinson's around 2015-2016, keeps changing jobs and is not able to work for longer periods of time as the native has to take sabbaticals to cater to family duties. Thanks for the feedback, Vishnu. It's 10:45. You know, I've been up since 4:30. Can Neeraj, can you stop the screen share? So we have a lot of more charts, you know, but I feel I hope how many examples we have taken is enough for people to understand. If not, then on Saturday I will try to take it from 7 o'clock. 8 o'clock will be Vinayak, but actually morning times are always best for me. That is the reason I always keep my courses in morning. By afternoon I start losing my energy. So do you all want me to take on Saturday? Some very good examples are there. I myself, if health permits, I will.
Yes, sir, that will be great.
Yes, please. Yes, chart, please, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Neeraj, just show the slides again. The slides where all the techniques are listed. Of course, some of the techniques which I mentioned verbally are not mentioned in the PPT.
Please take rest.
Bit tired.
No issues, sir. Please take rest.
Thank you, everybody, for your messages. Prince Verma, thank you.
Sir, is this?
Yeah. So, if people have not taken the screenshot of this, kindly do it. You know. But I hope people have understood broadly the techniques. And also do test the 36th year and 36.5 year for Rahu. Quickly, if I can have some feedback, we have finished 2 days of marathon sessions. If people can come on camera and give oh my God, I did not record this session, but I hope Amit Bhai has done.
Sir, don't worry, I have recorded this session.
Very nice. Upload it and send it to the office also.
Okay, sir, I will do.